Oh, shalom, shalom. I just want to welcome everyone to the New Moon Conference Call. And we're having a wonderful fellowship and worship today here together. And Brother Gabriel is here today, and he has a presentation for you. So welcome, Brother Gabriel.
Thank you, thank you, thank you for the opportunity to share with you the presentation that the Father gave me. Actually, he gave me the title in the middle of the night. I asked him prayer. I said, Father, what are you ready to teach me now? And in the middle of the night, I woke up and with this title in my mind, The Plot to Kill Yeshua. So I hope it's inspired. I hope it's an inspiration for all of us. The Plot to Kill Yeshua, or Truth versus Power, the Shaking in Israel. So this study is based on Matthew, mostly Matthew 26-27. And I will bring some verses from John, a few verses from John, but the foundation is the book of Matthew. So to understand what happened from the Gethsemane to Pilate court, this is this study is from the Gethsemane point to Pilate. I just want to prepare our hearts for the event that will take place in 2 weeks, the Passover event. So to understand the context, we need to understand what parties were involved, who was involved in this conflict, what was their understanding about the current situation, and some of them, they choose sides, not really understanding the whole picture. We need also to understand what was their mission, because the spiritual authorities, they definitely had a mission. Who would like to read Matthew 26, verse 3 and 4?
And they plotted together to seize Jesus by stealth and kill him. But they were
definitely had a mission.
Yes, yes.
They absolutely.
Yeah. Okay. Excuse me.
Yeah. So definitely they had the mission to kill him from the very beginning. So the context was Messiah came and basically he taught them in the temple, I am the truth, I am ultimate truth. That was the context. The disciples, they challenging themselves, who is the greatest? They didn't really understand that at this moment their mission, or they didn't have the clear understanding of the context. The multitudes were looking for miracles and the all glory of Israel. Spiritual authorities, high priests, priests, scribes and elders, they were afraid of losing the control upon the people, risking financial and spiritual power over them. The political authority also was afraid of losing Israel leaders and their partnership and keeping people under their control. They were also afraid of uprisings. So let's go into what Yeshua taught them in the temple, who he was and what did he teach. And Matthew 26:55, it says, who would like to read that?
I can read it now.
26:55.
Then Yeshua addressed the crowd. So you came out to take me with swords and clubs the way you would the leader of a rebellion. Every day I sat in the temple court teaching, and you didn't seize me then.
Thank you. So he was with them, teaching them. So his teachings based on John 14:6 were, I am the truth. This is who he was. And John 8:32, he emphasized, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. So who is the truth? Messiah, Yeshua. So in other words, he is saying, I am the truth, you shall know me. You shall know me and you will become free because you know me. John 8:36, if the Son makes you free, you shall be free indeed. So his mission in this context was to bring freedom and understanding. And John 17:17 said also, sanctify them to thy truth. Your word is truth. So basically here, Messiah and his prayer said, sanctify them through me, because of me, because I am your word. I am the truth. I came to bring them liberation. I came to bring them the good news. He said to Caiaphas also in Matthew 26:64, I am the son of Elohim, and not only that, you shall see the son of Adam sitting on the right hand of power and coming in the clouds of heaven. He would say to Pilate also on John 18:37 and 38. Who would like to read that? These two verses. John 18:37 and 38.
I have that.
Okay.
Therefore Pilate said to him, so you are a king? Yeshua answered, you say correctly that I am a king. For this I have been born, and for this I have come into the world to testify to the truth. Everyone who is of truth hears my voice. Pilate said to him, what is truth? And when he had said this, he went out again to the Jews and said, I find no guilt in him.
So if we try to understand and to pay attention to all details, when he said in the last part, everyone is of the truth, hear my voice, basically he's saying everyone that belongs to me, it's impossible to not hear me. And then you ask yourself, why other people do not hear? And the simple question is, because they do not know the truth, do not know him. They do not belong yet to him. So these were the teachings presented by him and brought him to this event, the Gethsemane event. So the conclusion are, you shall know me and I will bring freedom to you. No one can make you free as I do. I am the true freedom. I will bring freedom from spiritual slavery. Sanctification from the Father comes through me only. I define the truth. And everyone who is mine will hear my voice and understand me. I am the Son of the living Elohim, and you'll see me coming back as I promised. Heaven and earth will pass away, but not my words. My mission is truth and the good news of freedom in any circumstance. So this is a summary of what he taught them in the temple. Now let's see about the disciples. What was their understanding in that context? So they challenged themselves who will be the greatest in the kingdom. Still confused about who he is, they expected from him to do miracles in any circumstance. They saw their glory and power getting closer to him, pretending they understood his mission. They really did not understand the mission. They were looking for power. And Judah emphasized in Matthew 26:5, what will you give me? So all of them, they were confused, misguided, and still not mature spiritual to understand him. Let's see about the multitudes, their understanding. They were confused, easy manipulated by spiritual authorities and Roman power, without mission or any understanding whatsoever. They didn't know the scripture enough to understand and interpret his mission. They were easily driven by miracles. Used by the leaders in the first line, to Matthew 26:55, it says, come out against as a thief with sword and staves. Also were manipulated by the authorities in their decision to kill him and making the call, crucify him, crucify him. So these are the multitudes in that context. Now the spiritual authorities and their mission, because as we saw at the very beginning, they definitely had a mission from the very beginning. Afraid of losing control and power over the people, they decide to kill him, Matthew 26:3-4. They realize that he is a threat for them, and of course for the entire nation, and they manipulate and control the nation. They were in pursuit of power, and he was in pursuit of truth. So the spiritual authorities, they want power in any circumstance. Total opposition of what Yeshua did. He was in pursuing the truth in any circumstance. Also, they said it is better to lose one man than the whole nation, John 18:14. So, what is power? Power is possession of authority, control, and influence over others. So, in this moment, the Gethsemane moment, the disciples ran away, because they didn't understand the difference between truth and power. Truth in any circumstance is the greatest power in the universe, and that is Yeshua. I am the truth. Power without truth is dictatorship. It's criminal and will use any means to control, manipulate, influence, and even crucify in any circumstance. Power combined with truth means love and sacrifice. Power-focused people are blind. They focus on themselves. And the disciple of this moment, they cared only for themselves. They ran away. They ran away from him in the most crucial moment. Truth-driven people will look only for the other. The greatest example is Yeshua. Even in Gethsemane, he managed their emotion and fought for their cause. In this context, power without truth, see truth as a blasphemy. So let's see about the political authorities. According with the writer Hannah Arendt, power is the ability not just to act, but to act in concert. So the political power gives full support to Jewish authorities. Pilate did not find any wrongdoing, but still wanted to show solidarity with the high priest. Very compromised, morally individual. So now let's see and analyze together the reaction in Gethsemane, how Yeshua react at this confrontation. So he called Yehuda a friend, the one that he knew ahead of time that he will is going to betray him, right? He called him a friend. He told Peter to keep away his sword, and he proved, even in this circumstance, that he is the true shepherd. He claimed that the Father can provide 12 legions of angels, and he still didn't ask for that. He was so humble. He identified himself as the Son of Elohim, sitting, telling them that will sit on the hand, he will sit at the right hand of power and coming on the clouds of heaven. He didn't show any miracles. He confirmed himself as a king, no sign of power whatsoever. When he was provoked and beaten, he remained silent also. And the last, we can say that, you know, he was in his mission to do the, his mission was to do the Father's will. Your word is truth. So that was Yeshua's answer in Gethsemane moment toward all the others. The disciple reaction, they were power focused. Kepha or Peter, he said, I will never be offended. I will die with you. I will not deny you. And of course, all the other disciples said the same. When Yeshua needed them the most in Gethsemane, two times found them asleep. They were not able to offer him any comfort whatsoever. Absolutely not. Yehuda, one of the disciples, offered the betrayal kiss. Peter also smote the ear off of the servant. And the unexpected, the most unexpected to me, it was that all the disciples forsook him and fled. So in their pursuit of power and glory, they were clueless about their understanding. They were confused. And in the most, you know, the most difficult moment of his mission in Gethsemane, they flew away from him. Peter also followed from the distance, denied him three times, and then he went out and wept bitterly. All of them, they were confused and lost. The reaction of the multitudes in Gethsemane, the same, they were power focused. They came with swords and staves. They became false witnesses. They also, one of the false witnesses called him this fellow, the Creator's son, became, he was named a fellow. They supported the death sentence. They spit in his face, buffeted him, and smote him with the palms of their hands. Also, they sarcastically, they say, prophesy who smote you. Under the priest influence, they ask for Barabbas release. So these are the multitudes. People that they saw him, heard him, preaching, making miracles, offering them help, seeing the glory of the Creator and his attitude and his words, but they still have an unbelievable attitude towards him. They request Pilate to be crucified. His blood be on us and our children. They see their value only through their leader's eye. No spiritual maturity whatsoever. They see themselves, their value, and their thinking in total submission to the spiritual authorities. The spiritual authorities' reactions, the same power focused. They consulted themselves to kill him. They made an agreement with Yehuda for 30 pieces of silver. They brought false witnesses. They persuaded the multitudes to release Barabbas and destroy Yeshua. They challenged him to identify himself. They pronounced his testimony as blasphemy. They counsel again for the second time to put him to death. They said to Yehuda, "What is to us? What is to us? You sold him and is not our problem anymore. For us was the transaction a very successful transaction. It's your issue. You deal with it from now on." They took back the 30 pieces of silver and they purchased the potter's field. Intimidation and control is their mechanism in keeping people enslaved. So these were the spiritual authorities of Israel at that time. The political authorities' reaction, power focus, the same. Pilate engaged with Yeshua in conversation. "Are you the king of the Jews? Do you hear how many things they witness against you?" He called for the prisoner release. He also received the warning from his woman. He engaged with the multitudes in asking, "What shall I do with Yeshua called HaMashiach?" He washed his hands, "I am innocent." He releases Barabbas and he delivered him to be crucified. Now, the soldier attitude, it's under the political authority control, and what they did, they stripped him, placed a scarlet robe upon him. They beat him, using any means to keep their power. And now the conclusion, and then we're going to have the opportunity for comments. All who look for power will be powerless. All who are looking for the truth, who is Yeshua, they will have all power on their side. As he said in Matthew 28:18, "All power was given to me on heaven and earth." So that's a certainty. The power is in Yeshua's hands. And the last statement in Matthew 24:35, "Heaven and earth shall pass away, but not my words." That's a certainty. It's a fact that all power is in Yeshua's hands. Amen to that. And that concludes my presentation.
You know, I think at this point we'll close the recording so that we can have more of an open discussion, okay? So I'm going to go over there. Whoops.